Okay. So welcome everyone. This is the free Zoom before our Crisis Foundation class next week. So if you have any question, you're welcome to raise it, open your mic or type it in the chatting channel. 所以欢迎大家如果有任何问题的话,欢迎直接发言或者是在聊天频道提问。这场 free Zoom 是 为这个礼拜的 Chris 的 Foundation 那个基础课做准备。
Wonderful. Well, I want to start tonight by telling you guys a story.
所以 Chris 说他想要今天晚上想要先从讲个故事开始。
I first found Foundation and took the very first Foundation I took over 15 years ago.
我在15年前上了我第一次基础课。
At that time, foundation and bars was one class.
当时基础课跟 bars 是连在一起上的。
And a friend of mine introduced it to me, and I didn't want to do it at all.
那我有个朋友介绍我这堂课，可是我完全不想上。
This was the friend who was always introducing me to something strange.
因为我这个朋友老是做叫介绍我去做一些怪事。
It was either a new healing modality or a new channeled book or something about extraterrestrials and aliens.
因为他老是叫我去看什么新的心灵的学派啦，或者是外星人啊，或者是有谁通灵又新写了一本书啦，总是一些怪怪的东西。
And when I heard about it, I thought, no, I don't want to do this.
所以他叫我上这个基础课，我就第一个反应就是不要不上。
But I noticed something.
但是我后来注意到某件事情。
I noticed that all of my friends that were choosing to take access classes were getting much happier.
我发现那些我那些上基础课的朋友，大家都变得开心很多。
They looked much happier and they looked younger and they had more money.
他们看起来开心得多，年轻得多，而且也赚更多钱。
Friends that used to complain about life constantly no longer were complaining.
那以前那些一天到晚抱怨的朋友，现在都不抱怨。
So, I still had a lot of resistance.
可是我的抗拒还是蛮强的。
And there was a lady who was offering a class, and she needed a place to have the class.
那个时候有一位导师要开课，一个女导师，那她需要一个地方开课。
She was a facilitator from Australia who was traveling to Korea where I was living.
那是一位澳洲的导师，他要到韩国来开课，当时我住在韩国。
And I said, fine, you can have the class at my house.
那我就说，好，你可以到我家来开课。
But I don't want to do it.
可是我不上。
And as soon as the facilitator started reading from the manual, my attention was drawn.
可是那个导师一开始念课本、念手册，我的注意力就被他吸引住了。
She was saying things and talking about the way the universe works that I'd never heard anyone say before.
他讲的那些东西，还有他讲的宇宙运作的那些方式，是我从来没有听别人讲过的。
She was talking about how your point of view creates your reality.
他在讲你的观点是怎么样创造出你的实相。
She was talking about how you can change anything with a question.
她说你可以用提问来改变任何事情。
And from that moment on, I knew I wanted more.
那我一听她这样讲，我就知道我想知道更多。
And from that class, I have not stopped choosing more and taking more for 15 years.
那自从上了那一次课之后，就十五年来，我一直都没有停止去选择更多，去获得更多。
My life constantly gets greater.
我的人生变得越来越棒，一直都是这样，越来越棒。
And things that previously would have been a problem are not a problem.
那以前会是问题的那些东西，现在都不是问题了。
And this is why I have a special feeling for the foundation class.
所以我对基础课有特殊的感情。
Special feeling is a funny way to say it.
那说有特殊的感情，这个讲法也是蛮有趣的啦，蛮妙的。
but it truly is one of my favorites, and I think it is such an honor to facilitate.
但是基础课真的是我最喜欢的一堂课之一，而且我觉得可以教基础课是一种荣耀。
Every time I do it, no matter how many times, life gets greater.
那每次我教基础课，不管我已经教过几次了，人生生活都还是会变得更棒。
And to watch the people who come to class choose to transform their lives is so amazing.
那看到来上课的人，他们选择改变他们人生，这种体验真是太棒了。
So for all of you here, how many of you have done a foundation class already?
所以现场各位，有谁已经上过基础课了？如果可以的话，欢迎给个回应，可能做个那个比个手势什么之类的。
Berthold has, anybody else? Joan has, Yap has.
Yap 有上过，双子也说上过。
Okay, good. And a few others I'm seeing in the chat. TY is saying twice, awesome.
那 TY 说两次，太棒了。
Yeah. Nova 3i, also yes. Okay, cool.
So Nova 3 也说有。
Have you noticed your life has changed since doing it?
那你们有没有发现你们上过基础课之后人生就改变了？
Joan's nodding and smiling. Anybody else? I'm curious to know from you guys, what have you noticed has changed since taking the foundation?
所以就刚才在微笑在点头，那我很好奇你们注意到说你们上过基础课之后你们的人生怎么样改变了？双子 says, every time she took foundation, it's just different. Yeah, that experience is different. 那双子说后面每一次上都不太一样。
Exactly, and that's part of the magic of it.
那 Chris 说没错，这就是基础课的魔力之一。
No two facilitators are the same and no two classes are the same.
没有两个导师是一样的，也没有两场课是完全一样。
But every time we choose to run this class, it actually makes life greater for hundreds of thousands of people.
但是每一次我们选择上这堂课，它其实都让数以万计的人人生变得更棒。
So, yes, and someone's saying they function so differently. Exactly.
有人说这个每次作用都很不一样，或者说完，没错，就是这样。
Does anyone have any questions about the foundation or about access or anything with regard to access?
那可以说有没有人有问题，不管是关于 access, 关于基础课，或者是任何有关你的任何有什么问题都可以提出来。I have a question.
Yes.
So I heard a lot of facilitators says that every class is different andthe class belongs to you, you co-created the class, but sometimes I feel like in the class it's like I'm just sitting there and reading the manual. How do you have any hints for me to like make the class for me to like participate more in the class to create it more? 所以我的问题是很多导师都说那个基础课是属于你啊，你共同创造啊，可是我常常觉得说就只是在坐在那里看课文而已，所以可以Chris, 可不可以给我们一些建议，怎么样去更深入参与这个课程，一起去创造？
Well, obviously the class will get greater the more you're willing to receive.
那 Chris 说，当然你越是愿意去接收，这堂课就会越棒。
And sometimes receiving it means actually participating in it.
那有的时候所谓的接收是你要真的去参与。
Being engaged.
那你要深入去互动。
Now, what does engaged mean?
那这个深入互动是什么意思呢？
Engaged means you're receiving of everybody there and all of the energies that you're downloading.
那深入互动意味着你接收在场的所有人，而且也接收所有你下载下来的能量。
But you're also allowing your energy to be a part of everything too.
那你也允许你的能量去成为在场发生一切事情的一部分。
So, even if you sit in the class and listen or sleep and say nothing,
所以就算你坐在课堂上什么都不说，或者是你睡着了，
you will be receiving.
你还是在接收。
And even your receiving is a contribution.
那你的接收，哦，你就只是接收，也是一种贡献。
However, it can be even greater.
但是，哦，你还可以再更棒，还可以再更棒。
It gets greater the more you are willing to be a part of it.
你越是愿意去成为课程的一部分，那你的接收或者是这个课程给你带来就更多更棒。
The more you're willing to play an active role,
你越是愿意去扮演一个积极的、主动的角色。
The more you're willing to come with your questions,
哦，你越是愿意去提出你的问题，那就会课程就会给你带来更多。
So, to answer your question, Joan, yeah, you're going to change even if you just sit and listen and read the manual.
所以、回答 John 的问题，就算你只是坐在那里读课本，你还是会改变的。
But if you're willing to get more involved, it can be even greater.
但是如果你愿意更积极主动去参与，那你获得的改变会更多更棒。Thank you. I like really like what you say about putting your energy there. 所以我说，我觉得 Chris 说把你的能量放出去，就去参与那个课程，这个我觉得说得很棒。
Yeah. When you attend one of these classes, it changes your life, but everyone else who's attended, and even people that didn't attend.
所以可以说，当你去上这些课的时候，你的人生会改变，但是其他所有参与者、所有学员的人生，还有甚至没来上课的人，他们的人生也改变了。
When you come to class and you're willing to change even one point of view, that resonates out into the universe.
当你愿意来上课，然后你愿意去改变，就算只有一个观点也好，你的这个改变就会在整个宇宙产生共鸣。That's beautiful. 我觉得这个讲得真是太棒了。So we have a question from 双子。She asks, how can I share this strange thing with more people? 所以双子说，这个基础课，这个奇怪的东西，我要怎么样跟更多人分享
？Look.The only way that I know to share this stuff that works is this.
可是说我只知道一个方法 去分享这个东西。
You have to be these tools that are in Access.
你必须要去成为 Access 里面这些工具。
You can't sell it and you can't market it.
你不能去卖它，你不能就去行销它。
You have to just be it.
你得就是去成为它。
After 15 years of doing these classes, these tools are a part of me.
那我上了、开了十基础课，上这些课15年，这些工具已经是我这个人的一部分。
And as a result, people are drawn to my classes.
那也因此人们就受到吸引，会来上我的课。
But mostly because I don't require people to come.
但是最重要的是我没有需要人家来上我的课。
See, when you're selling something, you need people to attend so that you can be right for succeeding with selling.
因为当你在推销的时候，你就需要人家来上你的课，这样你的推销就是对的，你成功，你就是正确的。
But I don't need you to come.
但是我不需要你们来上课。
I welcome you.
我是欢迎你们来上课。
But it's your choice.
可是做选择的是你。
Does it create a greater world and a greater class? Yes, it does.
那在上课会创造更棒的世界和更棒的课程吗？会啊。
But you have to choose.
但是你得去选择，是你要选择。
So Berthold now has a question.
And he says, Berthold 有个问题。
How to stop judging?
你要怎么样才能停止评判?
Can you say something in your words and what you experienced?
所以你可不可以讲讲自己的经验，用你的说法来想一下如何放下评判?
Yeah, the easiest way to stop judging is you have to be honest with you.
那 Chris 说最简单的方式就是你要对自己诚实。
See, most people don't want to see their judgments.
大部分人都不愿意去看到自己的评判。
They don't want to see where they are being right.
他们也不愿意去看到说他们在哪里是在要去成为正确的。
And they love to be wrong.
他们喜欢去成为错误的，喜欢把自己看成错的。
So you've got to be willing to look. Where have you decided you're right, and where do you love being wrong?
所以你要去看看你在什么地方决定了自己正确，那你在什么地方你喜欢把自己当成错误。
And if you'll ask yourself that question every day,
那如果你每天都问自己这个问题,
you will start to see the hidden judgments you are operating from that you never get to see.
你会开始看到那些过去你藏起来，你一直根据它在运作的那些评判，过去你看不到，但是现在你会开始看得到。
And don't go on a witch hunt.
那你不要像是猎女巫一样，很极端。
Do you know what I mean by a witch hunt?
你知道我说的那个猎巫是什么意思吗?
A witch hunt is when you try to find all of your judgments so you can eliminate the problems.
你在猎女巫的时候，你是试图去把你所有的评判都通通找出来，你要消灭他们。
Relax.
放松一点。
Relax and enjoy who you are and the life you've created.
放松，然后去享受你所示的这个人，还有你创造出来的这个人生。
And just know that in time, you will become less and less affected by judgment.
那你要就放松去知道说，随着时间过去，你会越来越不受到评判的影响。
Because most of the judgment you're functioning from isn't even yours.
因为大部分你拿来运作的那些评判，他们甚至根本不属于你。所以还有没有人要提问的呢？赶快把握机会。
So, we have the foundation class starting in 3 days.
所以我们的基础课再过三天就要开始了。
And we would love to invite all of you to attend who would like to.
那任何想要参与的人，我们都欢迎你来参加。
So, if you're looking for more information, please speak to Joan, our wonderful translator.
所以如果需要更多资讯的话，可以找 Joan 翻译，翻译 Joan, 对。
Yeah, and also Yap, who's here on the call.
还有我们那个现场这个 Yap, 颜红。
Wonderful. Well, thank you all very much.
Sorry.
Go ahead. Is there more questions?
Amanda asked, can you say something about the five elements of intimacy?
The five elements, go ahead, translate.
Amanda 想问关于亲密关系五元素的事情. Okay.
The five elements of intimacy are designed to get you to communion.
那这亲密关系五元素，它是设计来让你可以进入共融。
They are honor, trust, allowance, gratitude, and vulnerability.
这五元素是尊重、信任、允许、感恩跟不设防。
The more you're willing to be these things,
你越是愿意去成为这些东西，
the more peace and communion you can have with you.
你就可以跟自己拥有更多的平和，更多共融。
And once you have those with you, you can invite people to your life that are also capable of that.
那当你对自己拥有这些亲密关系五元素的时候，你就可以邀请那些也拥有这些东西的人进入你的人生。
But don't ask to have those with everyone.
但是你不要去请求说，哦，我要跟谁拥有这亲密关系五元素。
Not everyone's capable.
不是每个人都有办法拥有这些东西。
Ask to be it with you first.
先去请求对你自己成为这五元素。Another question from Huawei Nova 3i. Can you talk about receiving and relaxing? 可以讲讲接收跟放松吗？
Yeah. Receiving is the willingness to be present for everything and the total download of all energies available.
那所谓的接收是你愿意去跟一切事物临在，然后完全去下载所有在存在在那里的能量。
And relaxation makes that easier.
那你放松的话，这一切这个接收就会简单很多，轻松很多。
And I'm not going to say anything more about that now, because some of these are big topics that we could go on for 3 hours about.
那现在我关于刚才说的那些我不讲更多，因为这有的是很大的主题，可以一口气讲三个小时。So another question?
Sure, I'll go do one more.
One more? So how do you go beyond control? 怎么样超越脱离控制？
To go beyond control, you have to get over your judgment that you know better than anyone else.
你要超越控制，你就要去克服你的评判，不要去认为说你比别人知道的多。
To go beyond control, you truly have to embody one of the elements of intimacy, allowance.
那要去超越控制，你必须要真的去成为亲密关系五元素之一，那就是允许。
You've also got to embody the element of trust.
你也必须要去成为信任这个元素。
And know that things will turn out exactly how you've decided they will.
那去知晓说事情就是会变成你决定会变成的那个样子。
And that's all I'm giving you guys tonight.
所以那就是我今天晚上就到此为止了。
If you truly would like change and truly would like more, please know you're invited to the class.
那如果你们真的想要改变，想要知道更多的话，请知道我是诚心邀请大家来上课的。
Awesome.
Thank you very much. Thank you. 谢谢大家。拜拜。